The stunning news tonight from the Supreme Court admitting a document from one of the most highly anticipated cases of this term was accidentally leaked. Good evening. I'm Norah O'Donnell, and thank you for being with us. Now, we don't know for certain that it is the final opinion that was uploaded and first reported by Bloomberg News, but if it is true, this signals the justices are poised to side with the Biden administration by reinstating a lower court order for now that allows hospitals in Idaho to perform abortions during a medical emergency. Why does this matter? Well, the Associated Press found that this year, Idaho had to medevac six women out of the state following a miscarriage, and they were not treated in an emergency room. The Supreme Court spokesperson confirmed the document was inadvertently and briefly posted online. This is the second time in recent years that an abortion opinion from the nation's highest court has been revealed ahead of the decision. It's an extraordinary breach of protocol. CBS's Jan Crawford covers the court for us and has new reporting.
The draft opinion in one of the most closely watched cases of the term was briefly and inadvertently posted on the court's website, and Bloomberg News grabbed a copy. If it stands as the final decision in the case, it would mean emergency abortions in Idaho could resume, at least for the time being, if a woman's health is at serious risk. Doctors in the state have put those abortions on hold, fearing prosecution, because Idaho's restrictive law allows the procedure only when the woman's life is in danger or in cases of rape or incest.
We are not legal lawyer people. We just want to practice medicine, standard of care that takes years, decades even to develop.
Idaho, one of six states that ban abortion except to save a woman's life, enacted its law 2 years ago after the Supreme Court overturned Roe v. Wade. The Biden administration sued, arguing those restrictive bans are at odds with a federal law that requires hospitals to provide stabilizing care in emergencies, care that could include abortions when the woman faced serious health complications. Idaho said its law allows doctors to perform abortions in those rare cases when a woman is facing irreversible health conditions. But a lower court agreed with the administration and said the federal law on emergency care overrode Idaho's ban. The administration had urged the court not to take up the case, and in the opinion posted today, five of the justices agreed to dismiss the case, saying it was too soon for the court to decide. Three conservatives dissented, saying the court should rule for Idaho. And the newest justice, Ketanji Brown Jackson, also said the court should move now, but to rule against Idaho.
And Jan Crawford joins us now. Jan, this could be so interesting. You could ask at this debate tomorrow night, would a Trump administration have sued Idaho to protect a woman's health? Do we know, though, when this decision could become public, but for real, by the Supreme Court?
No. I mean, we don't know. We've got more decisions coming tomorrow morning, then again on Friday, possibly into next week. And, of course, this is just one of those major cases that we're still waiting on as they wrap up the term. There are those two big cases involving former President Trump, whether or not he is immune from prosecution for his actions around January 6th, and if he's not immune, what can he be charged with? We won't know which opinions are coming down until they actually announce them from the bench. And like I said, that could be in time between now and sometime next week.
And we will break in tomorrow morning, Friday morning, with that news when it comes. Thank you, Jan Crawford.